Dance at Punahou can only receive a total of half a credit through the after-school PE department. The sports players receive a total of one credit through the PE department. Dancers train continually all year, while the sports players' season range from 3 to 6 months. I spoke with faculty and students to gain their perspective on the physical aspect of dance. Do you consider dance a physical sport?
Depends on what kind of dance. When we think about physical education, we think of a variety of activities. So there are some activities that maybe are not as strenuous, but within the 12 or 13 years that a student is here at Punahou, we hope that they get the wide variety of activities, the dance activities, the sport activities, some individual activities such as bowling, which maybe is not as strenuous. But as far as dance, I think aerobic dance, which isn't quite dance, is strenuous. Jazz can be strenuous. Ancient Hawaiian dance can be as physical.
I feel dance is a very strenuous activity in all levels, because it also composes all the components of physical fitness with your flexibility, muscular strength, and even endurance, because most dance workouts end up being a couple hours long, and even though it might not be sometimes as continuous, which is more of an aerobic and could be more anaerobic, it still is physically strenuous to the body.
Should dance receive more PE credit?
Basically, because dance is not a sport. Right now, our policy states that we are giving ILH credit only to sports. There are numerous clubs which dance would fall under, and there is even a dance club here that have asked for credit. But right now, because it's just a club, that's what our policy states, and that we feel that the sports right now, there's some of us even right now in our physical education department that feel that sports are even extracurricular and that it's different from physical education. Physical education doesn't stress the winning, doesn't cut people. So that's where there's some people even within our department that feel that maybe sports shouldn't even be getting credit, that we should be just getting our own physical education credit.
And the reason that ballet is given credit is because they meet two times, they fit the qualifications as far as also the having a curriculum, having met a certain requirement as far as class time, and which is what the ILH sports meet. And that's why they meet every day for 10, 11, 12 weeks. So they fit that criteria, that part of the criteria for class credit. When we met, and this I'm speaking about Mr. Al Rowan, who was the previous ASPE director, when we met with Mrs. Ng with the dance school, the one class that fit the time element was the ballet class. Now, if the dance school had more classes that fit that time, there's no reason that possibly jazz, you know, if they met twice a week and met the same requirement as the other ASP classes, that wouldn't be considered as a class.
Because there's a lot of things that students are doing extracurricular, but yet we still feel that's not physical education. And that's the bottom line, it's not physical education.
I spoke with Anya Chang, advanced ballet student.
Yeah, I think ballet should be given sports credit because we do the same amount of work as any team sport, plus we train year-round, so we should be able to get the same amount of credit as a three-month sports season, and it shouldn't be limited to half a credit of ASPE. If not sports credit, then we should be able to get performing arts credit or something for it, because I think it's unfair that we're only allowed to take 2 quarters of ASPE ballet for credit when some of us are taking it more than the required 2 classes, and we do it year-round.
As we can see, the student and faculty agree that dance is a physical sport and that it should possibly receive more credit, but there is nothing being done to change the amount of credit that dance receives. This is Jennifer Hill reporting for Punavision.